So not a whole lot just going on. Just had a snack before getting ready to get up and feed fish and reptiles for a couple of hours. Does take a while. And looked over and saw this. And I've seen him or her do this before. Completely out of cover, not hidden, not burrowed in the substrate. Of course, it's a boreal. I'm not able to show all the habitat from here, and I'm afraid if I move over, he's got plenty. He has plenty of stuff to climb on and does do that. And will outgrow this pretty soon. There's the resident NO that's been in there for 4 days, I think, now. The other one that's backstop, I guess you could say, should this one depart, is over with Nelson and living the life over there. It's got a big, huge place to hang out. Not as easy as thought, but it's actually crawled on Nelson.
It completely ignores it. So, I didn't do that intentionally, sorry. So let's get back to this guy.
Oh, see, all I had to do was move my hands over that way. No, there he is. Keep saying he. But watching me. And it makes me wonder if he wants me to try and feed him. He's a diurnal species, meaning he's most active at dawn and dusk, but definitely out during the day. Not so much at night. He's usually sleeping, and it's usually in his little cave that he made, the little cave that I gave him, or in one of the pots in there. Those plants have not been planted. They're just sitting in there, and some moss and stuff around them as substrate. So, and most of that toward the back. So it slopes upward. That ZZ plant is just about to burst open. It's got two new stalks that are just going like crazy in there. It's the easiest plant I've ever owned, I'll tell you. It's the big green one back there. It's got two of those stalks. I can't quite get over there, and I don't want to scare him. It's not worth it. There's a second one that's taller than that. So, that's what's going on. Here at Kaler's Aquatics and Exotics, I am going to try some tongue feeding with him just to emulate moving things. Since he's comfortable with me getting, I'm about three and a half feet, maybe a meter from him. And again, no idea if it's male or female, but while I was just watching a YouTube video a moment ago, I like to watch this series of people that are in accidents or crimes or whatever it's called, and they will kill you. And it's, you know, like it could be cars or sharks or anything, you know, but it's, and they will kill you. But I just watched a story on there about a Viking king named Sigurd, S-I-G-U-R-D, and he had was in a fight and had decapitated one of his enemies and put their head on the saddle of the horse. But before he was able to detach this fellow's head, he bit Sigurd, and Sigurd, of course, got infected, and back then no antibiotics or little treatment for anything like that, but he succumbed to that after all of his might and becoming king and all that stuff and being feared a simple bite from another person. So I think I shall call him Sigurd, S-I-G-U-R-D, and if it's a female, who the heck knows who Sigurd is. I just like the sound of it. And if he is a boy, he doesn't have to be a boy, he can be a female and still be a mighty warrior, right? So anyway, I'm going to try some tong feeding. I've got my trusty tongs here, and I'm going to thaw a couple of pinkies. And I see I've got others too that are reminding me that it's time to eat. You see me sitting here, and if it's too long in the evening, they've gotten accustomed to my routine that would focus. And Yibby does not bother those agamas, but he lays up top. Of course, he gets lots of heat coming out of there, and that's what the thing is. That's a wire cover on that. Now, he does not bother them. He does show some interest, and he watches them, but they're not the least bit afraid of him. They even come up to the wire and try to get his feet, you know, play with him. Oops, he went right back over there under him. Anyway, I get so distracted so easily. So I'm going to try the pinkies, and then I also got some wonder worms, or super worms, the green caterpillars, the moth caterpillars. I can never remember which is wonder worms and which is super worms. I got both, but I'm going to try tong feeding the green, big squishy caterpillars and see if he goes for that. And I'm going to put some dubia roaches in there. I hate to. I've got a colony of pets. Well, actually, I've got some that are smaller that I've had less time and that I don't really keep as pets, but I've never fed them except to the chameleons. So that's what's going on here. All kinds of excitement and plans and all that sort of stuff. And these guys are not out and about because they each had three pinkies last night. Flurry started it. There's Flurry. You hear me talking? These are such cool little snakes. Hears me talking. That's a wire top on there too. So he started it. He had three pinkies, and then Rosebud, I had to distract Flurry so he wouldn't come over and get a fourth one, took three also. And that's a first for both of them. So they're snoozing and trying to shrink those little bellies down. He would eat again, but it's supposed to be a no-no. I don't know how they know in the wild not to eat the next day, but, you know, it's like certain fish keepers and certain species of fish and things. We have people that know better than nature, and so you just have to go along with that, or you don't know what you're doing. Nature doesn't know. Okay, ran over. That's a good outro right there. Thank you, guys. I am going to get a fish video up again soon. I did one the other day, but I'm going to start doing some species, short species profiles of some of the newer fish that I've got and that are not that common. Trying to think of what kind of angels I got, and I can't. Bulgarian. Look at that. What a cutie. Oh. Woke him up. All right, guys, this is 9 minutes of foolishness. Talk to y'all later. Bye.